Minju, welcome back to my channel and happy, happy new year to you. How are you doing today and the past few weeks and the past year? I hope you're doing okay. In today's video, I really want to share with you the top three career realizations and lessons that I've learned from the past year. I always do this every year just because I want to see how far I've grown, and because you are a part of my community, I also want to share it with you. Now, if you're new here, my name is Rhea. Let me introduce myself again because I don't do that anymore in my past videos. I am a former BPO trainer, worked in a BPO company here in Cebu for 7 years, and I created this channel as some sort of an extension of my classroom training, and now I have this online space with my awesome community. So if you're just watching this video now, welcome, and let me know in the comments how you found me and where you came from, where are you located, and what stage of your career you are right now, whether you're applying in training or in production or just looking around. I'd love to hear from you, and I will definitely reply to your comments, so just leave it below. And if you like this kind of content, please don't forget to subscribe. Just click on the red subscribe button below. If you haven't yet, why haven't you? Tap the notification bell so that you'll be notified if I have uploads every single Friday. Twice about job stability. If there's one thing that we've learned in the past year, is that even though you are a long-term employee, a veteran, whether you're a frontliner or a leader, a manager, you're not really sure that you will be keeping your job forever, especially in times of a pandemic. Like, even though you are the best employee in your company, but if your leaders or the company will not find a way to save the company or the business, then it's highly likely that you'll not be able to keep your job the next day. And as sad as it can be, it's also a wake-up call to a lot of us, because, you know, we really have to step up our game. What is called stability previously is now no longer making sense to me, at least to me. You will have some form of stability, but you will only be able to really safeguard your future if you have other streams of income. And so that's what I've learned, and I'm very thankful that I was able to do that myself last year. I know that if you're watching this and you're a new employee, you're still starting to build your wealth, you're still starting to build your savings, and most of the time you'll probably not have enough savings to safeguard your future. And I know that because I've been there so many times, and until now I'm still very careful of not touching my savings and only touching it when there is an emergency. So right now I am encouraging you and actually imploring you to please set aside some funds for your savings. And it does not matter if it's big or small, as long as you have something there, eventually it will all add up, and you'll have something to spend when you really, really need it. The second realization that I have is that every one of us should always be learning and upskilling. So if you're watching this right now and your goal is to really just be part of the BPO industry, be a call center customer service representative, be a chat support specialist, tech support specialist, or whatever goal you have, it is not enough to just want to be a customer service representative, even though you are just in the early stages of your job application of your career. I want you to think ahead. So right now, you want to be a customer service representative. You want to start at the bottom of the career ladder, for example. Even though you are there, make sure that you plan ahead for your future. What do you really want to achieve And you can only achieve that when you're always learning and upskilling yourself. So just because you're a customer service specialist does not mean that you will forget about other things that you're skilled at. So maybe you're skilled in social media, in content writing, in maybe editing videos. So make sure you always, always nurture those skills because you never know when you need them. And I've learned that because working from home, I have tried handling several different things and so was able to hone my skills. And I'm very happy that I'm now at this point in my life wherein I can do a lot of things and not just one. And I can also hone in on my specialty at the same time. So again, I want you to think of your future. And that is also because I want you to be able to increase your earning potential as well. And if you increase your earning potential, that means you'll have more funds for your savings, more funds for your bills, more funds for your needs and for your goals and dreams. So at this point in your life, always think, I have to fund my dream. It's not just about providing for your family, it's also about providing for yourself, not just today, but in the future, right? And the best investment that you can do is on yourself. If your skill level is only level one, how do you expect your employer or your future clients to pay you more? How do you expect your future customers to hire you? So you need to be on level two, level three, and even the highest level that you can get at this point of your life. So instead of doing unnecessary things, set some time, schedule your day to learn a skill that will help you earn extra funds in the future. All right, I know that's quite a lot to take, but I'm really super extra right now because this is a realization that I have myself, that when I think about what if I just wanted to learn about one thing, then I won't be able to diversify and really choose where I want to be. I won't be able to ask my employers to pay me more or ask my clients to pay me more. So experience, you know, hone in on your experience and be confident with the skill that you offer. And in relation to that, I should mention that I've also launched my channel membership officially. And I'm not only saying this because I want you to upskill or always be learning, but it just is somehow related to it that my channel membership has officially launched last week. And in that membership, I will be having members only monthly, either live training or pre-recorded training for you. So if you want to check it out, I will link up here the video about the membership wherein I announce the membership, all the perks that you can get and everything you need to know about it. So go ahead and check it out. No pressure, no commitment. I just want to put it out there. So let's continue with the third career realization and lesson that I've learned in the past year, which is crisis leads to unimaginable opportunities. If you don't know yet, I actually resigned from my work from home job last year. It was my full-time job. Although I had a flexible schedule, it was still full-time for me. And I was doing that while I was maintaining this YouTube channel. And then in March 2020, I officially started a strategic partnership with MultiplyMe. They offer end-to-end staffing solution to companies all around the globe, and they hire Filipinos to be their remote employees. So all the job opportunities are work from home or wherever you are, because it's remote. And it was like the sign that I was waiting for, because last year I told myself, I really want to do something that aligns with the purpose that I have and something that revolves around this YouTube channel. So MultiplyMe came along. Actually, I got introduced to them last December 2019, so even before 2020. And then I officially joined them in March 2020, and I never regretted it because they were able to provide me the creative freedom and the control of, you know, what I really want to implement that will contribute and help grow their company. So if you want to also, you know, take advantage of a job opportunity that will really hone in on your potential and will also give you competitive and I should say fair compensation and benefits, as well as awesome team culture, then please go ahead and check out the link on the description below. You can sign up for a future opportunities program or check out the careers page, Facebook page. I also work with them internally as their social media manager. I post job opportunities every single week. And if it's not for you right now, that's okay. You can refer other people, you can share it to your network. But I really want you to come to a point wherein you believe that you are more capable than what you have done in the past. And in that case, I've also decided to level up my YouTube channel, wherein I will tackle things that a lot of people probably don't realize are important, which includes digital customer service, non-voice, social media, you know, things that you can actually do from the comfort of your home. Because, you know what, the BPO industry is not only call center. You can work in a call center and be a voice representative if you want, but know that there are also a lot of other opportunities out there for you. Last year, we were on a lockdown and a series of quarantines, and a lot of people were not able to work in an office. So the best time to start honing in your skills so that you can start working from home and remotely was years ago. But since you're watching this video, then the best time to do that is now. I have a playlist called Digital Customer Service. It talks about everything social media, digital customer service, I already mentioned that, non-voice, chat support, and anything that you can do to support your clients' customers in terms of, you know, online customer service. So link up there, and don't forget to share it with your friends as well so that they'll know that they have opportunities outside of taking calls. And I'm not saying that taking calls is bad or whatnot, because I've done that for so long and I've learned so much just talking with customers. In fact, I actually miss talking with customers over the phone. What I'm trying to point out is, I think I'm already repeating myself, what I'm just trying to say is that there are other opportunities that you can take advantage of. All right? So, if you want to continue learning and upskilling, don't forget to subscribe. Click the red subscribe button below and tap the bell for notifications so that you'll be updated if I have any new videos coming out. Thank you so much for watching, and I wish you all a happy and fruitful year ahead.